Hi everyone, this is Damien Fourcade from Layered Connectivity Technical Support Team. I hope you guys are doing good, very excited to be back for this new episode. Today we're going to talk a little bit of one of our most famous features, smartBASIC 80 Command Interface. Before to enter into more technical considerations, I think this is important to put all of this into context. So first thing first, what is smartBASIC? We know from experience and discussion with customers that any software integration development process can be tricky and laborious. It can sometimes even delay your product being on the market. Bluetooth Low Energy integration is no different. It demands a full overview and understanding of BLE protocol, which is constantly evolving and getting harder to work with release after release. At Layered Connectivity, we try to give as much as different programming options to our customers, and also, we believe that programming a BLE module must be an accessible experience. That's why we developed smartBASIC, our own event-driven programming language written on top of Nordic SDK. With its unique structure, it takes around 80% of the coding work from our customers. This is clearly our value added above and beyond what the market can offer today. Because not everyone can be a pro for coding with Defer, we are very proud to propose a different path to sweeten software integration pain. It is as much as stable than other programming language can be. Already thousands of customers are trusting it and use it into their day-to-day products and applications. Most our BLE products which integrate a Nordic chipset can support smartBASIC. Especially our famous BL65X family, BL654, 652, 653, BL600 and BT900. But also subcategories products like the BL654 USB dongle 451-03, BL654PA and BL653 Micro. Among all programming options we provide, which usually includes Nordic SDK, Zephyr and smartBASIC, if you opt for smartBASIC engine, you got different options. The first one is, without having to write even one line of code, you can leverage the smartBASIC engine as it is with making boot a BLE module into a mode we call Virtual Serial Ports or VSP. Because the Bluetooth SIG didn't adopt a serial port profile for Bluetooth Low Energy like they did for Bluetooth Classic, we developed our own simple cable replacement profile named VSP. It works in a way that once the connection is engaged, it literally bridges the UART to the BLE radio. Everything that comes into the module UART will be transmitted to the BLE radio and vice versa. In that way, if both BLE modules are aware of VSP service, they can exchange information through their respective UART via the most simple approach. The second option is where the 80 command comes. On top of smartBASIC, we have created a complete 80 command set that we call 80 command interface. This application code or software is all ready to be used and simply need to be loaded during production process. It has been especially tailored for use case where our BLE module is driven by an external host and allows to literally drive these modules with a very simple batch of commands. It will suit very well for easy BLE interactions like advertising, scanning, engaging a connection, GATT client server interactions, and running our virtual serial port service just explained before. The 80 command interface will be the option we will focus on today. And then last option, but not least, customer can write their own smartBASIC application using bunch of different function, sub-function, subroutines, event handler routines, and so on. I won't develop this approach here, but just be aware that smartBASIC can allow our BLE module to be driven in a hostless manner. For more information on smartBASIC core functionalities, you can refer on this link. This video also won't focus on how to download smartBASIC firmware and 80 commands interface app code. For this, you can refer on the following guide. To show you the practicality of the 80 command interface, I'll be using a good partner in crime, the Nordic Thingy 52 multi-platform sensor. Thingy is a useful and fun device that you might want to get and play with for every BLE development purposes, or even just for fun. You will find more information on the Nordic Thingy 52 here. This device works with a mix of Bluetooth SIG define and custom services and characteristics. To quickly get an idea on how Thingy services and characteristics are organized, I'll be using my phone, a Samsung A40 with the Nordic NRF Connect phone app. I'll be also using a BL654 USB dongle loaded with the actual last BL654 smartBASIC engine and the 80 command interface version. This dongle will be plugged to my laptop and I will use our cross-platform terminal software UwTerminalX to communicate with my dongle through USB to UARTCOM ports exposed by Windows. The purpose of the demonstration today will be to show you how much simple it is to use the 80 command interface to get connected and access Thingy various data. We will begin this demonstration by a quick overview of Thingy services and characteristics. To do so, I'll now power up the Thingy 52 and engage a BLE connection with using NRF Connect on my phone. The sensor will now play the role of GATT server and my phone will be the GATT client. Once we get connected, we can see the visual representation of Thingy GATT table. As you can notice, Thingy has loads of different services and even more characteristics. We can access typical service like mandatory generic access, which contains information like characteristics, device name, appearance, peripheral preferred connection, and central address resolution. As mentioned in their properties, these characteristics can be accessed by being read. If we read device name characteristics value from NRF Connect, note how the value is accessed in hexadecimal and then converted in ASCII symbol. Let's have a closer look now to environmental service . We can see that most of its characteristics works with notification. Notification is a property which you can subscribe in a way that every new value sampled will be sent automatically to the client. In that case, my phone. The way that you can subscribe to this notification will be to change the client characteristic configuration descriptor, or CCCD, which has the UUID 2902. For instance, to subscribe to temperature characteristic, you simply need to change the value of the CCCD from the hexadecimal value 0 to 1 with the writing arrow here. Just think to use little endian order. From now on, we'll get updated on temperature data in hexadecimal, which need to be converted as follow to be humanly readable. Now that we have all of this in mind, let's switch to the 80 command interface. Okay, I've plugged my BL654 USB dongle into my laptop. Here is UW terminal window. I've got the 80 command interface up and running. Now remember, my sensor is a server, so I will need to assume client role. The first thing we want to do is to scan for Thingy adverts. The related command will be 80 plus LSCN. It's quite intuitive. We can see that in response to my command, there are a bunch of different BLE adverts coming from device all over the area. Useful information are thrown into UART like MAC address, the RSSI, and the device names. For engaging a simple BLE connection without using VSP service, we will need to use the command AT plus LCON, followed by the MAC address of the peer we want to connect with. Okay, my dongle is now connected to Thingy. Available information here are connection handle, MAC address, and then followed by connection parameters. Once the connection engaged, we will then need to request Thingy GATT table with the command AT plus GCTM followed by the connection handle. There is a lot of information appearing on the UART because the Thingy 52 has a huge GATT table. You can see that every line corresponds to a specific attribute. S will stand for service, C for characteristic, and D for descriptor. At the end of each line, you have UUID's portions, which allow you to recognize which attributes you are dealing with. Each attribute has been allocated with an handle value. This handle will be important when you will want to access a given characteristics value. If you remember of NRF Connect GATT table visual representation, there is exactly the same information exposed, only on a different format. Here is the first service, second, third. Into the first service, you've got four characteristics, which corresponds to the characteristics we reviewed with NRF Connect. Device name, appearance, peripheral preferred connection, and central address resolution. So if we try to read the device name, I'll need to access the first characteristic of the first service which has been allocated with the handle 3. The command AT plus GCRD followed by the connection handle and the characteristic handle will allow me to read the device name value. We can notice that the value received is the same than before. You simply need to convert it yourself in ASCII. In the same way we did on NRF Connect, we will now subscribe to temperature value. Instead of reading, we will need to write using the command AT plus GCWA, followed again by the connection and characteristic handles, plus the value we want to write. Before to enter this command, we will need to determine where the temperature characteristic is and what is the value of its characteristic descriptor handle. So the temperature characteristic is located here, and one line below is its descriptor. The handle value attributed is 34. So to sum up, the connection handle is 1, the CCCD or characteristic descriptor handle is 34, and the value we want to write is hexadecimal 1, converted in Little Indian order. And there it is. We just quickly succeed of getting notified of new temperature value sampled by Thingy. Now we can disconnect using the command AT plus LDSC. And this is where this video ends. I hope you enjoyed it. If you'd like to have more information on our AT command interface, you can go on our website layoutconnect.com, choose one Bluetooth product that supports AT commands, and go down to documentation and have a look into our quick start and user guide. Thank you for watching, and see you next time for another episode.